And welcome to Vinyl Treasures. I'm your host, Johnny G, coming to you live each and every Saturday, only here on YouTube. We'll be joining Oldies and More Radio beginning at midnight tonight. Glad you can join Johnny G on the September 17th, 2022 Vinyl Treasure Show. I feature my 1950s and early 60s 45s out of my collection, all on original vinyl. And we'll be going from 9 p.m. Eastern Time till about midnight, as I said. But I usually go to 1. But I think I'll get them all in because I cut about 10 records out of the show. So it should be a quick moving show. I try to make it nice and rolling, as I normally do. We opened up with a cool instrumental there. Tenor saxophonist Hal Singer. I was looking for your request, Kenny Mack, but I didn't get a chance to find it, so I said, well, let me get another one. Charlene had some information on Mr. Hal Singer, but we opened up with Hal Singer and his orchestra, first recorded with the Roy Eldridge Orchestra back in 1944, I think, for Decca Records. And in 1948, he formed his own band, and in 48, he signed with Herman Lubinsky's Savoy Records. He had his biggest hit, a big number one record back then, on the R&B chart called Cornbread. And besides Savoy, he also recorded on Acorn and Coral, I think, in Mercury. And this was his fourth release on Savoy. Now, I didn't know this, but first presses of this came out as Mr. Movin's Groovin'. That's not how I have it. I have it, and that was in May of 56. Then a month later, it came out as Houndstooth. Now, I'm wondering, possibly, he called it Houndstooth because of the Buffalo disc jockey, George Hound Dog Lorenz. Maybe he used that as a theme song, possibly. But our opener tonight is from June 56, Hal Singer and his orchestra on the Savoy label with Houndstooth. Anyway, enough of my babbling here. Let's get to the vocal portion right now. And we open up out of the vaults of bandleader Al Brown. Now, this song was in Al Brown's closet for about 13 years before it was discovered. It was recorded in 1959, but not released till 1972. Someone by the name of Tony D'Ambrosio, He ended up buying the master and put it out on a label, his label, called A&G Records, and that was in 72. But this originally was recorded in February 59, and he purchased the master directly from Al Brown, and there was no name on the master tape. It was blank. They didn't know who it was. Al didn't remember who it was, but he decided to call them the Fascinations. I don't know why, but he just did, and of course it's with Al Brown and the orchestra. That's a definite. So our opener tonight, as I babble on, is from February 59, The Fascinations on A&G. It's called I'm Gonna Cry. Do-ba-da-ba. 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 One there issued in 1972 on the A&G record label, The Fascinations. That's what they'd called the group. They're not, that's not really their name though, but the label owner there, Tony D'Ambrosio, he called them that. February 59 release from Al Brown's vault, song entitled I'm Gonna Cry. Johnny G's not gonna cry, although I'm still kind of doctoring up this this biopsy taken on my leg, so you're going to have to excuse the shorts, ladies. So just excuse that as we continue here. You know, we count down the music chronologically here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. Lots of requests for tonight. We're going to open up here with an early side for listener Bob Evans, listening in Ohio. This group is out of Washington, D.C. They were managed by Lillian Claiborne, and she would shop all the groups she managed to various record labels, I think throughout the United States, mainly though on the East Coast and maybe down south. But she would negotiate a contract with RCA Records for this group called The Heartbreakers back in 1951. They had four releases on RCA and all excellent sites. Now, was Les Moskowitz, I think this is his label, Les Moskowitz was able to secure a number of the group's unreleased RCA masters. I don't know how he did that, but he did, and he put it out on his Roadhouse record label. I don't have them all, but I have some, and I have the one that Bob Evans requested. This is the second of seven on Roadhouse, issued in 1973, but recorded in 1952, written by the lead singer of the group. His name is Robert Evans. How appropriate. Bob Evans requested Robert Evans. Anyway, 1952. This is going out to Bob, the Heartbreakers on Roadhouse. It's called Hey Baby.
Hey, hey, baby. How could you leave me here to cry?
How could you leave?
Hey, 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 baby, how could you leave me here to cry? When you left me this morning, you didn't even say goodbye. Home this morning, I said, baby, where have you been? You just packed all your clothes and went right out again. No, 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 baby, you can't leave me by myself.
You can't leave me by myself, dude.
And if you don't come back, I won't want nobody else. Da 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 da. Come home, I've been so lonesome since that gal's been gone. I'll stay right here and cry all night and every day.
All night and every day.
And when she comes home, I'll say, hey, baby.
As going out to Bob Evans in Ohio, 1952, recording by the Heartbreakers. Robert Evans on lead there, the Heartbreakers. That's unreleased master, as Marvin Pod mentions. You know, Claiborne, Lillian Claiborne probably recorded them, and he ended up buying them. Les Moskowitz ended up buying them from her to put them out on his Roadhouse record label. There's some really cool sides on that Roadhouse label. The Marylanders, a bunch of groups. I was able to pick up some. I bought most of them from Ripley out in California. Unfortunately, he passed away, and I would buy from his brother also when he was on eBay, but I bought a lot of them from Ripley. He had a lot of those monogram reissues and a lot of the, even the vintage reissues for the Al Brown stuff. I have a lot of them, not all of them, but they're pretty cool because they're on color plastic. Anyway, there you go. That's for Bob Evans, the Heartbreakers from 52 on Roadhouse. Hey, baby. Let's move to 1953 now. Now, on last week's Vinyl Treasure Show, I played a request for Amnon. He wanted the Diamonds out of Harlem, New York, on the Atlantic label. Their second of three, called I'll Live Again. Amnon also requested the Flip Side, and it's a standard that dates back to 1931. So let's give a listen to this version, recorded October 29th of 1952, released in August of 53. It features Harold Sonny Wright on lead. This is for Amnon, August 53, The Diamonds on Atlantic. It's called Two Loves Have I.
Two loves have I, and they tear me apart. Two loves have I, both are in my
request for listener Amnon there, the great sound of the Diamonds out of Harlem, New York. August 1953 release on the Atlantic label, their second of three on Atlantic. Harold Sonny Wright, excuse me, on lead. Two Loves Have I is the name of the tune. How about a twin spin on the Atlantic label? Let's go back to Washington, D.C. now with this request for Kenny Mack in our YouTube chat room for the sound of the Clovers. They had 22 releases on Atlantic Records between 1951 and 1958. Kenny requested their seventh release. It features John Buddy Bailey on lead. We go to June 1953. The Clovers on Atlantic. It's called Here Goes a Fool for Kenny.
Here I go, a silly little fool. Ooh,
here goes a fool, wanting you back again. Here goes a fool. Whenever I pretend that you will never hurt me the way you did before,
again. My heart's trusting once more. Here goes a fool. The moment that we kiss, I know it's wrong, but I just can't resist you. The moment that I'm close to you, I know I'll forgive you again. And people will say, there goes a fool.
Here goes a fool.
Here goes a fool.
Thought in the dead. I know I'll forgive you again, and people will say, there goes a fool.
As going out to Kenny Mack in our YouTube chat room, the great sound of the Clovers there. John Buddy Bailey on lead. That's their second release on the Atlantic label, June 1953. That's before Johnny G was born. At least 5 years, a little longer than that. The Clovers there, the great on Atlantic, a song entitled Here Goes a Fool. Let's stay in 1953. Let's go to Nashville, Tennessee for this request for Tom Shaughnessy watching Johnny G on his 50-inch ITV. Got to say hello to Tom Shaughnessy. And this gal had two releases on Bill Beasley's Republic label. Now, Tommy requested her second. The tune written by Ted Jarrett, that name, I think, was, did he own Calvert Records or maybe the A&R guy for Calvert? A lot of stuff for Ted Jarrett on other Champion, other labels, Larry Bird song, a whole bunch of things. So I know that name. And this gal's name is Helen Foster. She's being backed up by a group called The Chapters, who have their own release, I think right before this one. But they backed her up. So probably she was in the studio after they recorded. She was up and they backed her up. I think their song was called Goodbye My Love. But this is from April 53. Helen Foster and The Chapters. This is going out to Tom Shaughnessy on Republic. It's called They Tell Me.
They tell me your kiss is just a moment. Promises I'll never receive. I know his soul, and yet it's so hard to night, and day after day, I tell myself, hope and pray that maybe one day poor slave to love, all bound in chains. I'll never be free.
Going out to Tom Shaughnessy there. That's Helen Foster and the Chapters there, April 1953 release. It's on the Republic record label. Song entitled They Tell Me. And what I say, that was her second, yeah, that's her second release on the label. We continue now, and we move to 1954 with a request for listener Emna. Now, this singer was a member of the Pilgrim Travelers when he was discovered by R&B and blues musician and record producer Bob Geddens, and began recording him on his Cavaliers label back in 1951. He would sell some of the masters to Aladdin Records for a bit before he created his own label, and he called it Big Town Records, and this artist put out 5 singles on the label. Now, Emnon requested his 4th from December 54. His name is Jimmy Wilson. Actually, it's Jimmy Wilson and his band. This is going out to Emnon on Big Town Records. It's called Jumpin' From 6 to 6.
My baby went out and stayed out all night long. Well, my baby went out and stayed out all night long. She told me a lie, she couldn't find her way back home. But she was jumping from 6 to 6.
Jumping from 6 to 6. Jumping from 6 to 6. Jumping from 6 to 6. Jumping from 6 to 6.
Now she called me up about 5:25, says, pick me up, daddy, don't want no jive. 10 minutes later, her boyfriend called and says, come on, baby, let's have a ball.
Jump from 6 to 6. I 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 jump from 6 to 6. She got herself in a happy place.
Come staggering in the door about 12:45. Asked me, daddy, did I do wrong? Stepped aside and draw it back. Split her right, dead in your eye.
Jumping from 6 to 6. 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 She got herself in everything.
God herself.
Cool R&B tunes here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. That's for Amnon there. That's lost my place. Jimmy Wilson and his band. December 54 release on the Big Town record label. His 4th of 5 releases on Big Town. Jumping from 6 to 6. It's Johnny G should be jumping from 6 to 6. Of course, he has later releases on Gold Band. I think Imperial also on the Duke label have those records in Johnny G's collection. Hope you're digging on the tunes. Hope the video's coming in better. I was playing around a little bit more with it to get it a little bit clearer here, a little bit more of a panoramic view maybe also. So I don't know, I'm waiting for my nephew to come in from Austin, Texas to come out and check, you know, all my connections and whatnot. So stay tuned for that. If you're new to the program, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Just click subscribe and also click the bell to get email notifications when Johnny G will be live. We are live right now here from 9 to midnight. We're usually here in overtime filling requests. If you have a request, you can send it to me at vinyltreasures@aol.com. If I have the 45, I will play it. Let's play this one. It is a request for listener Joe Shacatano. This group is out of Baltimore, Maryland. First recorded for Herman Lubinsky's Savoy Records as the Four Buddies. And their lead singer, his name was Larry Harrison. But after the group disbanded, Larry decided to form another group and call them the Barons. They recorded for the Decca label with two releases in 1954. Then in 55, the group signed with Phil Rose's Glory label for one release, and they changed their name, or Larry changed his name back, not to the Four Buddies, but to the Buddies. And this tune, written by lead singer Larry Harrison, this is for Joe Shacatano, March 1955. This is a hard record to find on the Glory label, the Buddies, with I Stole Your Heart.
I stole your heart, then drifted away. Should have known from the start that it wouldn't pay. Said goodbye, then you were gone. Now, oh, how I cry, for I'm all alone. When you're in love, in your eyes there's a glow. What was I thinking of?
I swear I don't know.
I stole your heart, then drifted away. Should have known from the start that it wouldn't pay.
Going out to Joe Shacatano there, the great sound of the Buddies. The Buddies on the Glory label, Larry Harrison on lead, March 1955, I Stole Your Heart. It took me years to find that record. I mean, I had a polished copy in my, I had to return it because it played horrible. And those people know who that person is, that you can buy the records and just return them to him. He didn't care. If you don't like it, send it back. That's what he said. I think one time I had to send him back like $1,500 worth of records because they did not play well. I mean, at least if you're going to polish it, at least make it play. It has to play decent. But, you know, don't deceive the buyer. I mean, I don't think that's a good thing to do. But, and I think, I don't know, maybe it's still going on. Remember, there's different kind of polishings. I know of maybe there's three methods. I know one is like a filler. The other one, it wears the record down. That is the worst because the fidelity ends up sounding crappy. Anyway, enough of my babbling here. Let's continue here. Now, on last week's show, I featured the Californians. The Californians, they were out of Los Angeles, California on Sid Nathan's Federal record label. It was a request. Joe Chacitano requested the Californians, and the song called My Angel was the group's only release. I think it was Marvin Pod and Daryl Letts that wanted to hear the flip side of this. Now, it features Harold Lewis on lead. This is from July 1955. These are the Californians on the Federal label. This is for Marvin Pod and Daryl Letts in our YouTube chat room. The song is called Heavenly Ruby.
Da, 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 da. Da. It's a lovely dream to wish for.
As I almost got caught there. Not quite Sterling, but anyway, there you go. That's going out to Marvin Pod and Daryl Letts. The Californians, July 1955, Harold Lewis on lead, Heavenly Ruby. I think I heard, for a few seconds, I think I heard Jesse Belvin's voice in there. He's definitely on the bridge on the flip side. You can definitely hear his voice. But those are the Californians. Now, Harold Lewis, he was a member of a number of Los Angeles groups, like the Lamplighters and the Tenderfoots and the J.O.'s and also the Sheiks that recorded for the Federal record label. We continue here. We are in 1955, and this is a request for Big Dave Swinger in our YouTube chat room. Now, these guys were U.S. servicemen stationed in Germany when they originally got together. They were called the Berliners. They were discharged in 1955. Now, the bass of the group, his name was Andrew Barksdale, and while he was in New York City, I guess maybe he ended up, they dropped them off in New York City, I don't know, he ran into his school-aged friend, And that friend was Mr. Jimmy Jones, and he asked him if he would join his group. They signed with Bess Berman's Apollo Records, and they changed their name from the Burliners to the Sparks of Rhythm. And actually, they left the name. They said formerly the Burliners. If you look at this 45 again, I had to quickly put it on the turntable. But anyway, this was their debut single, and it features the bass lead of the group, Andrew Barksdale, on lead. This is by request for Big Dave Swinger, August 1955, The Sparks of Rhythm on the Apollo label. It's called Woman, Woman, Woman.
Woman, what would you say, don't you ask?
Yes,
big mouth woman, we'll shut your trap. Well, I just can't stand your yippity-yap.
Hey,
big mouth woman, 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 shut your mouth. Holy, 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 holy woman, yeah, shut your mouth. God, you just what you talking about in the morning when I get up? I hear you quacking just like a dog.
In the evening when I get home, I hear you yakking on the phone.
Big mouth woman,
hey, shut your trap.
Well, I just can't stand your yippity-yap.
Woman?
Uh-huh.
Shut your mouth!
Big mouth woman! You're not here all night! Yes, big mouth woman! You're not here all night! Well, you just don't know what you're talking about! Oh, big mouth woman, 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 shut your mouth! Oh, big mouth woman! You're not here all night! Well, you just don't know!
Jimmy Jones coming in at the end there. Anyway, those are the Sparks of Rhythm. Sparks of Rhythm there. I don't think I've ever played that on the show, that side. Anyway, August 1955, the Sparks of Rhythm going out to Big Dave Swinger. Bess Berman's Apollo record label, Woman, Woman, Woman is the name of the tune. And that was the intended A-side too, by the way. Let's continue here. Let's go to Chicago, Illinois now. This is a request for listener Joe Shacatano. This is on Les Caldwell and Paul King's Drexel label. Now, the group had 5 releases on Drexel in addition to backing up Dorothy Logan, I think, on Since I Fell For You. That's a great record that she does also on the Drexel label. But they were called The Gems, and Joe requested their second release on the Drexel label with Ray Pettis on lead. This is from January 1955. This is going out to Joe Shacatano in our YouTube chat room. They give a listen to The Gems on the Drexel label. It's called I Thought You'd Care.
I thought you'd care. I was wrong. I thought you'd care for me alone. you told me that you loved me and said you'd always be true. Now this broken heart needs mending, and it's all because of you. If I love someone new, my new affair made no difference to you. My broken
out of Chicago on the Drexel label. Those are the Gems from January 1955. That's by request for Joe Shacatano. Ray Pettis on lead. I Thought You Cared is the name of the tune. That is their second release on Drexel Records. I normally play Kitty from New York City. They're not really known for their up-tempos, but I like that side too. But anyway, Ray would also have a couple solo releases on Drexel Records, plus other labels. I got some good ones by him. What is that Aqua label he's on? Is it Boss or Rick? Or I think it's Boss. Maybe it's Boss. I don't know, but it's a styrene record, but it's good. Power of Love or Something of Love. That's a good record, though. I have it. Anyway, Johnny G babbling on. Here we are in 1955. Let's go to Newark, New Jersey now with this request for Daniel Kubacki in our YouTube chat room. This gal born Cynthia Coleman. I think she recorded, was it the Coleman Airs, I think she recorded for? The gospel group. I have a couple of their records. I don't have them all, but I have a couple on Apollo. But she recorded as Ann Cole, first recording for the New York City Timely label. I have a couple by her on Timely, and she signed with Saul Rabinowitz's Baton Records for 10 releases, and I'm including the last two that Baton turned into like Sir Records, so I'm including all of her 10 there. Now, Daniel requested her first, and this is, I think, the B-side. I think Are You Satisfied was the A-side of the 45, but this is, or at least played on the radio, but this is the B-side, a tune written by Lou Sprung and Phil Rose, and they would eventually, and this is like close to them, with their, they own the Glory label, so, but this is going for Daniel, Ann Cole from November 55, this is her first release on the Baton label, it's called Darling, Don't Hurt Me.
I'm on my knees, begging you please, please, please don't leave me, baby. Your love I need. Do me a favor,
one little favor. Darling, don't hurt me. My heart is gone, gone. Your love I want. Without you, baby, I can't go on. Do me a favor, just one little favor. Darling, don't hurt me. Darling, don't hurt me.
That's Miss Ann Cole by request for Daniel Kubacki. That's her first release on Baton from November 1955. Darling, please don't. No, Darling, Don't Hurt Me is the name of that one. She would have two more on, I think one on MGM in 1960. And then her last one came out on Roulette Records, September 1962. Have both those 45s. We move into 1956 now. Now, on the August 6th Vinyl Treasure Show, I played a request for listener Joe Shacatano. He requested Sonny Woods and the Four Winds. Came out on Emmanuel Middleton's Middletone record label. The song was called Do You Love Me? That was their first of two on the Middletone label. Now, Mike Sape, who is in our YouTube chat room, he requested the flip side of this 45, and he wants to dedicate it to fellow listener George Tompkins in our YouTube chat room. I apologize for the view on that, because this webcam, they kind of overdo it on the colors, and it's notorious for that, but it's got more of a kind of like a clearer picture in general, so you got to get the good with the bad here. But anyway, so this is by request for Mike Sape, dedicated to George Tompkins in our YouTube chat room, February 1956, Sonny Woods and the Four Winds on Middletone Records. It's called I Promise.
I promise that I'll always love you. Place no one above you. Won't you be my baby? I promise always to be faithful. Never be ungrateful. If you be my baby, I'm always thinking maybe someday you will give your heart to me. Oh, 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 I promise never to desert you. Never, ever hurt you. If you be my baby, I'm always thinking of you. Wherever I may be, but I'll hope and pray that maybe someday you will give your heart to me.
That's the first of two for Sonny Woods and the Four Winds on the Middle Tone record label. By request from Mike Sape in our YouTube chat, and that's dedicated to listener George Tompkins there. February 1956, Sonny Woods and the Four Winds, I Promise. I Promise on Middle Tone Records. Now, the interesting thing is that all the band members get mentioned on the label. Unfortunately, you couldn't see it with this new webcam, but it's the Ernie Freeman combo, and Ernie Freeman, he's on piano. Irving Ashby, he's on guitar. Joe Comfort is the bass. R.D. Martinez on drums, and Plaz Johnson on the sax. Can't get any better than that, folks, for your instrumentation. I'll hire them for my wedding when Barbara and I get married in the year 2075. So we'll see as we continue here. Let's go back to Harlem, New York now with a request for listener Ronnie Sherman. Ronnie, I got your email late last week, so we're going to play them this week. This group first recorded for Eddie Heller's Rainbow record label, followed it up with releases on Old Town, Riviera, G Records, and David Miller's Trans World record label. I think this is like a subsidiary of Essex Records out of Philadelphia. Trans World is a subsidiary of Essex out of Philly. But this one also came out on Caravan, which I have. But this is on the Trans World record label. They're called The Five Crowns, and it features Wilbur Yonke Paul on lead. This is from June 1956. This is going out to Ronnie Sherman. The Five Crowns on Trans World. It's called I Can't Pretend.
I can't pretend that I don't love you or don't think of you. Every night I can't pretend that I don't miss you, don't long to kiss you or hold you tight. I'm sorry for the things I've said to you. My words were so unkind. Or can't you see that I'm not playing? I'm only saying I can't pretend. I'm mine. I lie awake dreaming of you. Can't get you out of my mind. So darling, please try to believe me. If you should leave me, my life would end. For can't you see that I'm not playing? I'm only saying I can't pretend.
That's the great sound of the Five Crowns. That's going out to Ronnie Sherman. Ronnie Sherman featured it on the first label, Transworld Records, June 56, I Can't Pretend. Wilbur Yonke Paul on lead there. Johnny G Can't Pretend. I'm playing original vinyl 45s. I apologize for some of the pops and clicks and whatnot, but Kenny knows they sound so authentic in his headphones. And also I apologize for some of the colors, especially the red ones. I don't know, it's kind of weird. It's like with the back, I don't know. I'm gonna play around with it a little bit. Let's continue here. Well, this is a request for Big Dave Swinger. This group is from Roxbury, Massachusetts. Now the group's second biggest hit was a song called Ka-Ding Dong. They followed it up with this tune, and the main lead for the group was Ray Gibson, but some sides included another lead. His name was Teddy Scott, and he's doing lead on this one. This charted number 22 on WCOP in Boston, Massachusetts. This is on Cecil Steen's Pilgrim label. This is by request for Big Dave Swinger in our YouTube chat room, September 56, The Sound of the G-Clefs. I first heard this on the Gus Gossard Show. Pilgrim Records, it's called 'Cause You're Mine.
Whip, whip, tum, tum, I love you so. Whip, whip, tum, 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 I love you so. 'Cause you're mine.
'Cause you're mine.
Mine.
Well, I really miss my baby. So. I miss you so.
Whip,
I spend all night, I cry for you.
So.
Want you to know you're
whip,
for me.
For you. My love is true.
'Cause you're mine. 'Cause you're mine.
Mine, mine.
Well, I really lost my
love you so.
And you know why?
Whip, whip,
that every day I left you,
my love you so.
All day I cried, you're for me,
for you. My love is true.
'Cause you're mine.
'Cause you're mine.
Mine, mine. You're for me.
Because I love you so.
Well, I really lost my head.
So.
And you know why?
That
very day I left you, baby.
All
day I cried, you're for me.
For you. My love is true.
'Cause you're mine.
'Cause you're mine.
Mine, mine.
You're real good.
'Cause you're mine.
Mine, mine.
You're all mine.
'Cause you're mine.
Mine, mine. 'Cause you're mine.
There you go, John G playing around with the lights in here. That's going out to Big Dave Swinger, September 1956, The Sound of the G-Clefs here on the Vinyl Treasure Show, 'Cause You're Mine, the name of the tune, Cecil Steen's Pilgrim Records for that one, and their biggest hit, of course, was in 1961 on the Terrace label. It was called I Understand. I'm not a favorite of Johnny G's, though. I like Sitting in the Moonlight much better than that. Johnny G has just turned off all the lights, but I turned off the lights here? How is the view? We're going to play a couple records, at least with this light off on my desk here where I play the records. So maybe it'd be a little bit different. Is it a little darker? I don't know, but let's see. Check it out. Check it out. But let's continue here, and let's go back out to Los Angeles, California with this request for listener Tom Shaughnessy. It's on Johnny Otis's Dig record label. Now, he previously, this singer, was a previously lead singer of The Crowns, but this was his debut solo single, and although The Crowns are still backing him up, but this is, but it came out under his name, but they don't get mentioned on the label, so they are uncredited. It's the first of two on Johnny Otis's Dig record label, a tune written by Johnny Otis together with the lead singer. I'm talking about Arthur Lee May. So this is by request for Tom Shaughnessy, November 1956, Arthur Lee May and the Uncredited Crowns on the Dig label. It's called This Is the Night for Love. This is for Tom.
This is the night for love. This is the night for love. And everything all right for love. The moon and stars above are shining so bright. Well, I know this is the night. Ooh. Now this is the night for love. I'll hold you in my arms. I'll give you all my love and all of my charms. Well, I know this is the night.
Going out to Tom Shaughnessy. I love that record there by Arthur Lee May and the Uncredited Crowns, November 1956, Johnny Otis's Dig record label, This Is the Night for Love. Of course, Arthur Lee May would work two jobs. Imagine working two jobs. One as a singer, the other as a professional basketball player of the 1959 Milwaukee Braves. Got to ask Brian Korn, you have any 1959 Milwaukee Braves cards of Lee May? I had them. I had them like, I think, 1965 or whatever. I forget what team he was on. My father threw them out. I had them in a shoebox from 65 to 65, I think, to 69. So they toppled over in our, we have like a tool room down in the basement. I had them in there. So they toppled over and he threw them out. He threw them in the garbage. I was so upset, you know. And the only one I could find, I think I had a Boog Powell card, a Roberto Clemente, like hit, you know, solid hitters or whatever. I was Ups. I had a Willie McCovey, I think I found. A Willie Mays, I found. They were on the Giants. I was upset because I used to, you know, I was a great flipper. I used to be able to flip like 300 cards all one way. Did you ever play that with your buddies? Or colors, or, you know, positions. But I was a big baseball collector, and I used to watch it too, but no more. As we continue here on the Vinyl Treasure Show, so we just heard a song called This Is the Night for Love. How about a song called This Is the Night? Because I like this tune also. Is it good? We go back to Chicago, Illinois. This group had two releases on Vivian Carter's legendary VJ Records. They were named after the WGES disc jockey. His name was Herb Kent, the Cool Gent. That was his nickname. And they were hoping that Herb would end up managing them, but he turned them down. But he said, you know what? If you want to take the name for me, go right ahead. That's pretty good publicity. You can do it. So they called themselves the Cool Gents. And it was actually D. Clark, who I don't know what he did up at the radio station, but he brought the group up there and they asked him to perform with them. And he actually was a member of the group. D. Clark was a member of this group. So they went to a Universal Recording Studios in Chicago on November 3rd of 1955. They recorded four songs, and this was their debut single. Came out in February of 1956. Now, D. Clark is not doing lead on this one. He does lead. I think the group also recorded as the Delegates, and he does a lead on one of those Delegate releases, also on VJ. But the lead singer on this, his name is John McCall, and this is their first of two on VJ. Both are excellent in my opinion, but this is February 56, the Cool Gents on the VJ label. It's called This Is the Night. That's the first of two for the Cool Gents with a K. The Cool Gents there, February 56 on the VJ record label. This is the night. This is the night Johnny G plays original vinyl. It's every Saturday from 9 Eastern till midnight and mostly overtime as we continue here. We are in 1956. Let's stay in Chicago with a request for Bob Evans, listening in Ohio, and been featuring some cool songs by this group, the Great Flamingos, over the last few weeks. Now, after they left Parrot, the group signed with Checker Records for 9 releases. Now, Bob requested the B-side to their 3rd release. The A-side was called I'll Be Home, the great Nate Nelson on lead. He's also doing lead on the flip. He actually wrote this tune also. So we're going to send this one out to Bob Evans in Ohio, January 56, the Great Flamingos on the Checker label, the great Nate Nelson on lead. It's called Need Your Love. The great sound of the Flamingos. That's going out to Bob Evans, January 56 on Leonard Chess's Checker record label. Nate Nelson on lead. Need Your Love is the name of the tune. That's a B-side. We move into 1957 now with a request for Timothy in our YouTube chat room. This group had a 2-year contract with Bobby Robinson's Fury record label, and after it ended, Bobby sold 2 of their masters to George Golner, who put them out on his N record label, and this was the group's first of 2 on End Records, and it features Frankie Lyman's little brother on lead. So this is going out to Timothy, listening in our YouTube or watching in our YouTube chat room. August 57, give a listen to Lewis Lyman and the Teen Chords on the Black and Silver Print End label. It's called Too Young.
Well,
Kitty Leeds here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. That's going out to Timothy in our YouTube chat room. Louis Lyman and the Teen Chords there. August 1957 released the first of two on George Gulner's N record label. Too Young is the name of the tune. You're never too old and you're never too young to tune into the Vinyl Treasure Show. Hope you're digging on the cool tunes tonight. If you have a request, you have to send them to me in advance, because I have to pull the records out of my collection. I have hundreds and hundreds of boxes of 45, so when you give me the requests, I have to go into my record room and I have to pull out these boxes of records that are alphabetically filed. And they're not only group records, they're also R&B. I'm trying to take the soul records out of there, because I had some of the rare soul records mixed in, so those are coming out. And those are going to be in another whole collection. I also have another collection that's just all pop music and British Invasion and, you know, like Connie Francis and Pat Boone and all those hits. In case I want to do a countdown show, but I doubt it. When am I going to have time to do a countdown show? I want to do an R&B countdown show with some group records on it. That is a definite. But anyway, thank you all for tuning in tonight. Hope you're digging on the tunes. Hope you're hearing some you're adding to your want list, or seeing some you haven't seen in a while. That is my goal. But here's a request for my number one California listener, Matey Campboy, and it's a duo, as they both were ex-members of the Squires that recorded for the Vita label. Now, Bumps Blackwell, he was instrumental with bringing them over to Art Roop's specialty label. They were Don Harris and Dewey Terry, a.k.a. Don and Dewey. They had 7 releases on specialty records. Now, Matey requested their second release. Now, this charted number 41 on KUDL in Kansas City, Missouri. So this is going out to Matey Campboy, August 1957. Don and Dewey on the specialty label. It's called Leaving It All Up to You. This is for Matey.
I'm leaving it all up to you. You decide what you're gonna do. Now do you want my love?
Whoops. That's by request for Matey Camp Boy there. The great sound of Don and Dewey. They had 7 releases. That's their 2nd on the Specialty label. They both wrote that tune, August 1957, leaving it all up to you. And I knew Kenny would say, well, wait a minute. No, that's the Dale and Grace tune. No, they copied it from them. They covered it. Actually, they had a bigger hit. Of course, they had a number one national hit in late 63 on Montel Records on that song, Dale and Grace. But that's the original going out to Matey Camp Boy. As we continue, we are in 1957, and here, this next group, they formed at the Omaha, Nebraska Technical High School, first singing gospel, but their manager, Paul Allen, was able to get them an audition with Johnny Otis, who was touring the state of Nebraska at the time. And Otis was instrumental with them signing with Don Robey's Duke record label out of Houston, Texas. The result were 4 releases. Now, listener Mike Sape requested their 4th release, and Mike would like to dedicate it to all you listeners and collectors and music lovers in the chat room. So this is Mike Sape dedicating this tune to all of you in the YouTube chat room. The song written by the lead singer of the group. His name is Willie Barnes. We go to September of 1957 for the Sultans. The Sultans on the Duke label. It's called If I Could Tell. Requested by Mike for all of you listeners.
If I could tell what this feeling deep inside, if I could tell, then I wouldn't hide my pride. I'm afraid to say that I love you more each day. If I could only tell, if I could only take your little hand in mine, if I could only feel your lips close to mine, then I'd tell you so. What my heart knows is true. If I could only tell, oh, I wouldn't hide my pride. I'm afraid to say that I love you more each day. I'd tell the world
you're mine.
I'd say that
you'd be mine.
I'd
say I love you so.
And
I'd
never,
never let you go.
I'd
tell
the great sound of the Sultans there. Very cool song requested by Mike Sape. Sent out to everybody in the chat room there. September 1957, their 4th release on Don Robey's Duke record label. If I Could Tell is the name of the tune. Willie Barnes on lead there. Now, Braden, you mentioned it. A notable member of this group was Gene McDaniels, who would go on to have a very successful solo career on the Liberty record label. You know his hits, 100 Pounds of Clay, Tower of Strength, Chip Chip, a whole bunch of other releases on the Liberty record label. And of course, this group also would record as the Admirals on the King label, two great records by the Admirals on King. Played them here. Time to play those again. Hope you're digging on the tunes, guys, as we continue here. And on last week's Vinyl Treasure Show, I featured the Cufflinks. The Cufflinks at Sacramento, California, for listener Amnon. He requested How You Lied. Came out on Dootsie Williams' Duto record label. That was their second release for Duto. Featured Leroy Barber on lead for that one. This is their follow-up. That was their follow-up, is what I meant, to Guided Missiles. And I like Guided Missiles. Some people don't like Guided Missiles. I like Guided Missiles. That featured Robert Truesdale on lead. Well, Robert's back again doing the lead on their third Duto release. And this is a request for Daniel Kubacki in our YouTube chat room. The tune written by Alfred Gatewood. This one from August 57. These are the Cufflinks on the Duto label. It's called It's Too Late Now for Daniel.
Time is running out, a new love I found.
It's too late now.
For Daniel Kubacki there, the great sound of the Cufflinks. The Cufflinks, Robert Truesdale, the lead singer on that. Dootsie Williams, Duto record label from August 1957. It's Too Late Now is the name of the tune. The flip side is an instrumental with, I think he's playing saxophone on that record on the flip side there. But again, there was even one other lead singer for this group, Henry Houston, also a lead singer amongst other groups, but he was a lead singer of the Cufflinks also. Let's continue here on the Vinyl Track. Vinyltreasure show. We go back to New York City with a request for listener Emnon. He requested Tony Middleton, the lead of the Willows. This is on George Golner's Gone record label. This is a cover song. It dates back to 1933, covered by hundreds and hundreds of artists and singers. And for you collectors out there, this 45 comes two ways. I think one just lists Tony Middleton, and others, like the one that I'm playing, says Tony Middleton with the Willows, and that's how I have it. This is from October 57. This is for Emnon, Tony Middleton with the Willows on the Gone label, and his rendition of the tune Let's Fall in Love.
Why shouldn't we fall in love? Our hearts are meant to be. Let's take a chance and let's close our eyes. We can make our own paradise. And little we know of this, still we can try. Though we might have been meant for each other, to be or not to be.
That's the sound of Tony Middleton and the Willows there. That's on George Golner's Gone record label. His rendition of the tune, Let's Fall in Love, that one there from October 1957. Bought that from Ted Artkowski about 25 years ago. He was selling some of his 45s, and I was able to get that one in nice shape too. Anyway, let's continue now, and let's move into 1958. Now, last week, on last week's show, I featured the Olympics out of Hollywood, California. They're second of three on the Demon label. That was a request for Kenny Mack. He requested I Want to Dance with the Teacher, but I think it was Evan, excuse me, Evan, I think it was you, and also Butch Ford that asked Johnny G to flip it over. Now, it's one of the rare ballads by the Olympics. They didn't really do a lot of ballads at all. They have a nice one on the RV label, and this is another one they have. This is written by Fred Smith and Cliff Goldsmith. They were the A&R guys for Demon Records at the time. So we'll send this one out to Butch and Evan, November 1958. The Olympics on the Demon label. It's called Everybody Needs Love.
Everybody needs love. Love has done to me.
I was fooling at the start,
darling, at the start.
Till one night in the dark,
one night in the dark,
something told my heart you and I would never part.
Needs love.
As going out to Butch Ford and Evan Blatt there, the ballad, a ballad by the Olympics. The Olympics, that's their second release on the Demon label from November 1958. Everybody Needs Love is the name of the tune. We are still in 1958. Let's go to the Bronx, New York now. And this is a request for listener Big Dave Swinger. This duet had 11 releases for Zell Sanders' JNS record label between 1956 and 1963. Now, you know their signature song. It's a classic from 1957, Over the Mountain, Across the Sea. If you have that one on the first press, JNS Records, Chess Records, of course, picked that up amongst other records of theirs. But Big Dave requested their sixth release for JNS. This tune written by Rex Garvin. They are Joe Rivers and Johnny Louise Richardson, better known as Johnny and Joe. So this is for Big Dave, December 1958. Johnny and Joe on the JNS record label. It's called Warm, Soft, and Lovely.
Well,
Jazz going out to Big Dave Swinger, the sound of Johnny and Joe. That's Johnny Louise Richardson and Joe Rivers there, December 1958. Warm, Soft, and Lovely is the name of that one on the Zell Sanders J&S record label. Of course, the Clickettes, they would cover this tune in early 1959 on the Dice record label. I have a copy of that their record for that too, and it's always fun to find records like this out in the wild for a quarter. That's what I found that one when I was a kid, when I was a teenager in high school looking for 45s, and that one popped up in somebody's box for a quarter. Anyway, a lot of fun to collect records back then, and we are in 1958. Here's a request for listener Ronnie Sherman. This group lived on 115th Street in Manhattan. It's the same apartment building as the Bop Chords, and it's unfortunate that they only had two releases. They both came out on labels owned by Danny Robinson, and the group consisted of first tenor Herb Jennings, second tenor Irvin Jones, baritone Ron Clark, the bass was Douglas Jackson, and the lead singer, his name is Johnny Jackson. And their first single came out on the Holiday label, and it was called Counting the Stars, and the flip is a ballad. What was it called? I Want to Know, I think. Yeah. And this was their follow-up, their second release on the Vest label. Tune written by their manager. His name is Les Cooper, or was Les Cooper. This is 1958. Give a listen to The Ladders. This is for Ronnie Sherman, The Ladders on the Vest label. It's called Hey, Pretty Baby.
Bio, bio, bio. Bio, bio, bio.
For Ronnie Sherman there, the great sound. Great sound of The Ladders there, 1958. That's on the Vest record label. Hey, Pretty Baby is the name of the tune, and Johnny Jackson, the lead singer on that. For you collectors out there, the true first press of this should not have the stars around the logo. So check your copy on that. Plus, it's smaller print than the original, so it's easy to tell, easy to tell for that, but that was like a big seller in the early 60s. Slim Rose or some of the radio stations would play that record. Actually, both sides of the record, great two-sided 45 by the Ladders. Let's continue now, and here's a group from Shreveport, Louisiana, but they had this lone release on Pappy Daly's D label, which is out of Houston, Texas. Not really a label, not really known for vocal group harmony, but this is a request for listener Joe Shakatana. Now, the group consisted of a Buddy Seepaw, Ben Nordine, Bob McGee, and I think the lead singer on this, his name is Brad Ingalls, because he wrote the tune. That's a guess. It's not a definite here. But this is on the D label from September 58. This is going out to Joe Shakatano, the four B's. The four B's, I guess, because everybody had B in their name. There you go, their first names. Buddy, Ben, Bob, and Brad, the four B's. I have to apologize for the quality, because this doesn't play. I have terrible luck with the D record label. I wonder how my Chantilly Lace plays. I never checked it. But anyway, this is for Joe Shakatano, the four B's. It's called I Played the Fool.
Yes, here I go again, down this road before I've been. It's the road to lonely land and broken hearts. You broke my
B's, because their first names start with B. They are from Shreveport, Louisiana, originally September 58 release. I Played the Fool came out on the D record label. Now, three of those members would later record for Mercury as the Sherwoods. As we continue, here we are, have one more in 1958, and it's a request for my number one California listener, Mady Campoy. Now, this is a husband and wife team. They were known as the Lovers. They were Alan Bunn and Annie Sanford, and some of you may know them as Tar Heel Slim and Little Ann. Now, this was This one came out on Eddie and Leo Messner's Lamp record label, and they used to look for new talent in some of the major cities, even here in New York. Some of the artists on the Lamp label, they are from the New York area, and this was their second of three for Lamp, a tune written by Alan Bunn, a.k.a. Tar Heel Slim. This is going out to Matey Campoy, February 58. The Lovers on the Lamp label. It's called Let's Elope. This is for Matey. To Matey Campoy there. Those are the Lovers. They're really a duet, of Tar Heel Slim and Little Ann, a.k.a. Alan Bunn and Annie Sanford there. The Lovers on the Lamp record label, Let's Elope. Yes, Ryan, another Let's Elope. I'll be flipping that Extremes record for you later on as we get to that year. Let's continue now, and we are in 1959. We go to Detroit, Michigan with a request for Daniel Kubacki to Devorah Brown's legendary Fortune record label. It's the debut single for this group that consisted of three brothers and their father. Now, the lead singer, he goes by the name of Armand Abney, and he would also later record as Orlando King on the Fortune record, or Arlando, A-R, I think it's A-R-L-A-N-D-O, Orlando King on Fortune. But this is their first of two on the Fortune label, and Armand not only is singing lead, but he also played guitar on this, and their father, who was their manager, is also singing bass on this. So this is for Daniel Kubacki, November 59. These are the Earthquakes. The Earthquakes on Fortune Records. And does Braden have a 78 of this? The song is called Bashful Guy.
Boom, 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 boom. Bashful guy, is it the thing that I feel down inside? Is it okay after you pass by? I'm just a bashful guy.
Boom, 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 boom.
Bashful guy, you know I've known you for a long, long time. Oh, how I can't make you mine, but I'm a bashful guy.
Yeah, that talking at the end there. There you go. That's the Fortune. That's the Fortune label there. And that has a weird cold ending too, unfortunately. But there you go. That's for Daniel Kubacki, The Great Sound of the Earthquakes, November 1959. This record has become pricey over the last couple of years. The Earthquakes there with Armand Abney on lead. Bashful Guy is the name of that one on Fortune. That's going out to Daniel Kubacki. We are in 1959. Let's go out to Cincinnati, Ohio for this group. First recording for the Teenage label back in 1957, but later that year, they signed with George Golner with releases on his Mark X, Cindy, and Gone labels. Then in 59, they signed with RCA for 6 releases, and their second release would be a major hit for the group. It was a song called Shout, a big number one record for them. I think it was number one, but it was a big hit for them. But they also recorded some excellent ballads, and here is one requested by listener George Tompkins. Gonna have to check it out on the archive. It's the B-side to their first release on RCA. It features Ronald Isley doing lead on this. So this is by request for George Tompkins, May 59, the Isley Brothers on RCA Records, a great ballad. It's called Turn to Me for George.
If tomorrow's hard to face, and your blues are hard to chase, if you don't know who to turn to, wanna cry, but your eyes are always dry. If you don't know who to turn to, turn to me.
Going out to George Tompkins there. Nice sound by the Isley Brothers. They can do ballads too. May 59 release, the Isley Brothers with Turn to Me. Came out on RCA Records. Ronald Isley on lead. And in 61, I think they moved to Atlantic. They had 4 releases on Atlantic. I think Write to Me is another nice ballad they do. And then, of course, they went to Wand, and then they went to a whole bunch of other labels. But a big, long career for the Isley Brothers. As we continue here, we are in 1959. Now, on the March 26th show of this year, played a request for Joe Shacatano by the Royal Jacks, a group from the Bronx, New York. It was their second overall release, came out on the studio label. It was called Night After Night. They had an earlier release prior to that on 20th Century from 1958. But this second release came out in November 59, and Ryan Heisey in our YouTube chat room requested the flip side. So we're going to send this one out to Ryan from November 59, the Royal Jacks on the studio label. It's called Who, What, Where, When, and Why for Ryan.
Listen to me, lover. Please tell me and don't lie. I've got to know the answer. Who, what, where, when, and why? Who was the guy that you were with last night? What did he say when he held you tight? Where did you go that made your love burn? When, my darling, oh, when will you return? Why, please tell me, why did you go astray? Did you leave and break my heart and turn all the way? Got to know the answer, why you make me cry? Please love with me, baby, who, what, where, when, and why? Who was the guy that stole your love from me? What did he say to change your destiny? Where did he tell you that your heart belonged? When, my darling, did I ever do you wrong? Why, please tell me, why did you go astray? Did you leave and break my heart and turn another way? I got to know the answer, why you make me cry? Please level with me, baby, who, what, where, when, and why? What did he do to change your destiny? Where did he tell you that your heart belonged? When, my darling, did I ever do you wrong?
Did I do you wrong?
That's going out to Ryan Heisey, the Royal Jacks. Royal Jacks on the studio record label, November 1959. Who, what, where, when, and why? Those are the questions that Johnny G gets all the time. I think Vinnie Catalano involved with that 45. We are 1959. Here's a request for Evan Blatt. Well, at least I think you asked me if I had this record, Evan. I don't know what it was. Might have been on the birthday show, Johnny G's birthday show. But this is on the Gaiety label out of Minneapolis, Minnesota. And I would think either Brian Korn or Braden McCullough would find these records up there. But they can't find any here. So I need a better copy of this one if you can find it. But the group is from St. Paul, Minnesota. They're called the Valquins. And it's their only release. It features John Stafford on lead. We go back to June 1959. The Valquins on the Gaiety label. We'll send it out to Evan Blatt. It's called Falling Star.
Darling, I still love you so. But there's one thing I want you to know.
Oh,
We'll send that one out to Evan Blatt, who left to go to sleep. So left to hear that one on the archive there. That's a rare 45 by the Valquins, June 1959 on Gaiety Records. It's called Falling Star. John Stafford, the lead singer on that. And Jerry Smith, the late Jerry Smith, used to meet him up in Waterbury, Connecticut. And he unfortunately died in a head-on collision. And I don't know what happened there. I just found that he passed away. Used to sell on eBay, but I used to see him up at that show. And he had a lot of the WPEP singles that I purchased from him in my collection. And he sold me that. He said, "Johnny, you've been such a great customer for me. I'm going to sell you this record for $50. He sold this to me for $50. And I'll forever be thankful. I will not forget him. And I still have all the things that he was a big New England Patriot fan. I remember that. But that is a cool record and a rare 45. They have the Sting. That was the group. I have a rare instrumental on there also, the String Kings. Brian just mentioned it in the chat room here. We continue here in 1959. We go back to the Bronx. Kenny, you've been requesting all these Bronx 45s. So maybe Big Dave Swinger, he'll take you to the Bronx, and you can listen to this group. They recorded two for the ABC Paramount subsidiary Apt Records. This is their second. Their first was called Dance, Dance, Dance. Now, their second was another three words. And the lead singer, his real name is Steve Glasser, but he recorded as Scott Stevens. And he wrote this tune. I think at this time they were known as Scott Stevens and the Cavaliers. I have a better copy of this, Brian. I couldn't find it. So this is my... And again, you know Johnny's feelings about styrene 45s, but this is from March of 1959. Let's give a listen to Scott Stevens and the Cavaliers. This is for Kenny Mack on the Apt label. It's called Why, Why, Why. Not with the cough.
Why do flowers bloom in spring? Why do robins fly and sing? Why do trees swing and sway? And the deer all run away? Whoa! Why won't you tell me why? Why do lovers hug and kiss? Walk and talk and reminisce? Dance and date and stay up late? Call each other up at eight? Tell me why. Look at the lovebirds, see them making love. I will be your pigeon if you only be my dove. Why do I love you so much? Why do I turn to your touch? I will never once deceive if you only will believe. Whoa, why won't you tell me why?
Go. Those are the Cavaliers. The Cavaliers on the Apt record label, their second release. Lead singer there, Scott Stevens. He co-wrote the song. Didn't write it, co-wrote it. For March 59, that's going out to Kenny Mack. Kenny Mack in our YouTube chat room, why, their follow-up to Dance, Dance, Dance. Johnny G here on a Saturday evening. If you have a request, you can send it to me at vinyltreasures@aol.com. If I have the 45, I'll pull it out for you. If I don't, then, you know, like Jimmy Amato asking me for that Mathematics of Love. I don't have that, Jimmy, and I can't answer you on my YouTube pages because it won't let me. I can't click like, I can't comment, so either you have me blocked or you made it so nobody can comment. So I can't, when you type on my YouTube page, Johnny, do you have this or you have that, I can't answer you. It won't let me do it, so I have to take time on the air and tell you. So you can't do that. You got to be able to communicate with me. Either you send me an email or you call me on the phone or you do something. I talk to a lot of listeners. Don't I talk to a lot of listeners, Jerry? I do, as we continue here on the Vinyl Trail. And speaking of Jimmy Amato, he requested this side on the, as we move into 1960 now. It's a flip side from my August 27th show. The group is out of Cleveland, Ohio. It came out on Gene Carroll's GC label. And I played a song called Fading Away, requested by George Tompkins. And Jimmy, I think you asked me to play the flip, and this is actually a cover song. This was done, I think, it was written by Duke Ellington, and I think it was first recorded back in 1934 by Joyce Jenkins. But let's move all the way up to 1960, even though it sounds earlier than that. But this is for Jimmy Amato. These are the Carousels from 1960 on GNC, and their rendition of the tune, Solitude.
In my solitude, you haunt me with memories of days gone by. In my solitude,
I'm filled with despair.
Very nice rendition there. That's going out to Jimmy Amato there. The Carousels. Carousels on GNC Records. Their rendition of Solitude. It was recorded in 1960. You can tell by the RCA matrix number on that. That's how that record was dated. It's got an L. I think it's an L. I think that's 1960. But that is a nice rendition there. That is a great tune. We continue here. We are in 1960. This next group, they're from the Bensonhurst section of Brooklyn. They were managed by Jim Gribble, who also managed the Mystics. And this 45 was issued twice, first on the LG label in June of 1960. It was then picked up by Lost Night in April of 61. I'm featuring it on the first press, LG Records. And this is a request for Ryan Heise in our YouTube chat room. I purchased this record originally blind when I didn't know anything about this 45. And again, I tell my students all the time, if you see Tico Wilshire on the label, you must buy the 45. And I think a Big Dave Swinger, he mentioned that in the chat room, but the conductor on this is Tico Wilshire, in any capacity. Anyway, this is for Ryan Heise, June 1960. They're called The Visions on the LG label. It's called Teenager's Life.
Dum 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 dum. A teenager's life is just what it seems, heart built on hopes and a life full of dreams. The candy store where everyone goes.
Thought of me in teenage,
going steady, staying out late, rocking and rolling with your date, going to drive-ins and wrecking hearts.
That's the sound of The Visions there. That's going out to Ryan Heise in our YouTube chat room, The Visions. From June 1960 on first label LG Records, Teenager's Life is the name of the tune. You can also get it on a pink styrene, I think it was pink styrene, a Lost Night label. I think that's how I have it. Anyway, we are in 1960. We go out to Hollywood, California to Gary Paxton's Paxley label with this request for Butch Ford, listening over in Hawaii. He's probably out to lunch now, you know, because they're way ahead of us, 6 hours ahead out there. So, you know, California 3, Hawaii 6. I think it's 6. But this record produced by Gary Alley-Oop Paxton, Kim Fowley, and Bobby Ray. Now, this would get picked up by Lou Bedell's Doré record label in March of 1961, which is the easier way to find it, although I don't have it. I don't think I have it on Doré. I have it on the first label, Paxley Records, issued in October of 1960. The lead on this, his name is Ken Mower, M-O-W-E-R-Y. So this is going out to Butch Ford from October 1960. These are the Fascinations on the Paxley label. The song is one word. It's called Why. This is for Butch. Go. That's going out to Butch Ford there. That's a rare four. I think it's pretty rare on the original label, the Paxley label, but it was picked up by Dore Records. Marvin Pod wants to hear the flip side. Okay, we'll play the flip side next week for Marvin Pod. October 1960 on the Paxley label. Ken Mowery, M-O-W-E-R-Y, the lead singer there, The Fascinations, with a song entitled Why. That's going out to Butch Ford as we continue here. Now, up next, a request for Joe Shakitano. This is on Charlie Fitch's Sarg. Thank you, Charlene. I don't know. I always get confused. Is it Sarge? No, it's Sarg. You got to pronounce it S-A-R-G, the Sarg label, which is out of, is it Lulling, Texas or Luling, Texas? You know, Johnny G gets the pronunciations really screwed up here, but it's Lulling, Texas, I guess. Yes. Did I say it right, Reed? Lulling, Texas. Anyway, the group is from Gonzales, Texas. They had 6 releases on the Sarg label. This was their second, written by band leader for the group. So when you see O.S. Grant, he's the band leader. He's not the lead singer. He's the band leader, and he wrote this tune. The lead singer on this is Charles Leitard. Charles Leitard, he is the lead singer. So this is by request for Joe Shakitano, July 1960. The Downbeats on Sarg. Yes, on Sarg. It's called I Need Your Love for Joe. Da, da, da. Sterling is going to yell at me because I got caught here. As we're talking about sergeants and everything, Johnny G got caught here with the 45s. As we were getting luling or all that messed up, I messed it up there. I'm sorry, folks. But that is a cool tune there by the, lost my place. There you go. The Downbeats. The Downbeats, July 1960, going out to Joe Shacatano, Charles Lightheard. He's the lead singer. Ois Grant. He was, I think, Charlene, what was he, the sax player? I think you said he was the sax player. Yes. He was a sax player. That's on the Sarge label. So we always have to think that the owner of the label, Charlie Fitch, he was a sergeant in the Army. That's how we got to think about this. Anyway, let's continue here. Here's a request for Jimmy Amato. Jimmy, I remember you requested this record. This group is out of Brockton. Did I say that right? Brockton, Massachusetts. And this is on Frank Pappalardo's Casa Grande label. This is the same label that the first press of Happy Happy Birthday Baby by the Toon Weavers came out. But this was a label out of Woburn, Massachusetts, and it's the debut single for this group. They're called The Blends. They were really big in Brockton, Massachusetts, but this is their first of two. I think they have another one that was came out in 76, if you want to say they had three, but they had two true legitimate release. I don't want to call them legitimate versus illegitimate, but anyway, this was their first. Big John Croft, he's the lead singer on this, and this is for Jimmy Amato. August 1960, The Blends on Casa Grande. It's called Now It's Your Turn. That's going out to Jimmy Amato there, The Blends from August 1960 on the Casa Grande label. Big John Croft, he's the lead singer on that. Now It's Your Turn is the name of the tune. Now I remember who I purchased this record from. For $3, I paid $3 for this record. Mike Michelle was his name. He was a record dealer out of of Boston, met him at a Connecticut record show when record shows used to be on Friday evenings. I forget who took my, Mike Layton and a bunch of his friends. They said, you want to go to a record show? When? Friday night? Okay. So they drove up there. I don't know where in Connecticut, but it was when shows were at nighttime on a Friday, which was pretty cool in the hotel there. So he was there. I met him. He put me on his mailing list, but I didn't like the way, you know, because the people that were closer to Boston were getting the lists first. That's my gripe with Victor Perlin. So I'm like, you know, Victor, you're going to send me the list. By the time I get it, I'm running thousands of labels. So I run thousands of labels, and I'm picking, you know, Little Esther for 275. Then I'm picking Oldies 45s that I was collecting. You know, I was picking stuff from the 60s, some soul records. So it takes me, and he's got like 2,000 records in the listing. So I send him the list, and you send him the money, and then he tells you what he has, and I'm like, you're giving me $3 records. It's not working for me. So then he said he was going to send it to me via email, but I got it. I got it the day before I got it in the mail. What good does that do me? So I can't buy from Victor, unfortunately. But I've gotten records from Victor in the past. But I just don't do it anymore. I can't look at lists because I was running labels. So and I'd send a request. I send it in for $10,000. Doug Hanners was great with me, I will tell you that much, when I was buying records, because I would get a preview before. But again, I'm not talking about, you know, four records. I'm talking about, you know, 345s that I was buying that was filling labels at the time. So those were the good times for me. I mean, at least if you're going to be a big buyer, then you do it that way. So it wasn't like I was going to cherry pick. So, why am I talking about this? Anyway, say you're getting this is the Collector Teacher Show. All Johnny G's little innuendos. Anyway, let's continue here now. We've heard from the Blends. On last week's show, I played the Extremes for listener Ryan Heisey. Came out on Danny Robinson's Everlast record label. The song was called Let's Elope. And Ryan, I think you also asked me to play the flip side as well as listener Daryl Letts. So let's send it out to Daryl and Ryan, 1960, the Extremes. On the Everlast record label, the flip of Let's Elope. It's called Come Next Spring.
But what can I do? You know. oh dolly, that I'm still in love with you.
There you go. That's for Daryl Letts and Ryan Heisey. Those are the extremes. The extremes from 1960. It's on Danny Robinson's Everlast record label. Come Next Spring is the name of the tune, as we're gutting into fall, though. But we had really nice weather the last couple of days. Today started to get a little bit warmer. Tomorrow, Barbara tells me, it's going to be back up to 86 and humid. I don't like that. We continue here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. We move into 1961 with a request for Jerry Nazen in our YouTube chat room. This group is from the Fort Greene section of Brooklyn, New York. And it's their only release, and it's actually a cover song. This tune, a hit for Earl Lewis and the Channels back in 1956 on the Whirling Disc record label. Now, it features Carol Berry. She's the lead singer on this. Let's go back to August 1961. These are the Magnificent Four. The Magnificent Four came out on the Whale record label, another styrene 45. This is going out to Jerry Nazen, their rendition of the tune, The Closer You Are.
Na 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 na
August 1961. They like that tune there in the YouTube chat room. That's by request for listener Jerry Nazen. The Magnificent Four came out on the Whale label. Their only release is called The Closer You Are. You can also get this, I think it came out in Blast Records too in 1963, if you collect that label. I think it's a painted on label, if I'm not mistaken, like a purple color painted on label that I hate. Anyway, Johnny G here on a Saturday evening. We're going to be joining Oldies and More Radio pretty soon there. Hope you're digging on the tunes. If you're new to the program and you're finding out and watching me on YouTube, tell your friends about it and please subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'll be back on next Saturday night for more 50s and early 60s. And Wednesday night, I do an all 60s show. I feature soul 45s out of my collection. So if you're into soul music, tune in to that Wednesday night show beginning at 9 p.m. We continue continue here. We are in 61. Let's go back out to Los Angeles, California, to Elmo E. Bridges label with a request for listener Butch Ford. Now, this group is called The Bishops. They earlier backed up Walt Rio. I have that record. Walt Rio on this label. And on this release, I guess it's just the group. It says The Bishops with the Mellow Tone. So, are they the instrumentation group? I don't know. But anyway, this is by request. Going out to Butch Ford, 1961, The Bishops with the Mellow Tones on the Bridges label. It's called The Wedding.
I made a vow. To love and to cherish, to have and to hold for the rest, yes, the rest of your life.
I look into her eyes and I say,
going out to Butch Ford there. Those are the Bishops. The Bishops with the Mellow Tones. I don't know if Walt Rio is on lead there. I mean, why wouldn't they still mention Walt Rio and the Bishops again? I don't know. So I wasn't sure. 1961 release. It's on the Bridges record label. It's called The Wedding. Let's continue here. And up next, a request for Kenny Mack in our YouTube chat room here. It's from the Roxbury section of Boston, Mass. Kenny, are you from, not that I'm asking, you can give me the state, but are you from Massachusetts? You've been picking some Boston records tonight. It's on Skippy White's Ditto label, and the tune written by Bruce Patch and the lead singer of this group. His name is Johnny White, W-Y-C-H-E. So this is going out to Kenny Mack, December 61 release for the Sequins, the letter C-Q-U-I-N-S, the Sequins on the Ditto label. It's called You've Been Crying. This is for Kenny.
You've been crying.
That's going out to Kenny Mack. I haven't played that record in a long, long time. I'm usually playing the flip side, you know, the cover of the Falcons tune. What is it? My Only Love? I forget. But that's a cool flip side. I think the flip side. Sequins there, December 61. That's for Kenny Mack. You've Been Crying came out on the Ditto label. Now, the Masters, Skippy White would sell the Masters to Chess Records, and Chess re-released that record in February, or they released it in February 62. So I guess maybe for national distribution, I guess, I don't know. But anyway, let's continue here. And you can go, Mr. Vintage fan, if you go to my YouTube, page and you click on the right side, there's a button there. It says bio. If you click that, you will read Johnny G's bio, what I did, how I got here, and how I collected all these records. So instead of typing it in the YouTube chat room, you can check it out that way. So please do that. Let's continue here, as it's almost ready for the Oldies and More crowd. As up next, a special request. This is a special request for my number one California listener, Mady Campoy, as she requested this tune, but she wants to dedicate the song to her mother, Marie, because Marie was instrumental with Mady becoming a listener to the Vinyl Treasure Show. She told her about her mom told her about my show, and ever since, Mady has been a listener. And her requests, everyone tunes in to listen to Mady's requests. So Johnny G is happy to have Mady as his number one California listener. I have a number one Arizona listener too. I don't know, maybe there's one in every state. But anyway, thank you, Mady, for this request, and thank you for being a loyal listener to the show. Now, she requested this tune. The lead singer of the group, he's from Jacksonville, Florida, and he was a member originally of a group called the Joylarks that recorded for the Snag label. And he relocated to Allentown, Pennsylvania, and he formed another group, and he called them the Floridians. And this was their only release on the ABC Paramount record label. So this is from February 61. These are the Floridians on ABC Paramount. And it's by request for Mady Campoy, dedicated to her mom, Marie. The song is called I Love Marie, for Mady and her mom.
I love Marie, I love Marie, Marie.
I love Marie,
I love Marie.
I knew how love was meant to be. Just me for you and you for me. Until eternity.
request from Mady Campoy, dedicated to her mom, Marie, the great sound of the Floridians. February 1961 on the ABC Paramount record label, I Love Marie is the name of the tune. George Lucky Lloyd on lead. I think they also became Jay Proctor joined him. What was the group? Is it the Selections? I'm getting confused here. It's on the Jordan label. Johnny G is losing his mind for a Saturday evening. Want to welcome in the Oldies and More Radio Network here to the Johnny G's Vinyl Treasure Show. I spin original vinyl 45s every Saturday from 9 p.m. Eastern Time to midnight. And we are currently in overtime when we join the Oldies and More Radio Network. Thank you for tuning in, folks. We are in the year 1961. Let's go to Wilmington, Delaware for this next 45. Came out on Vince Rago's Universal label. And is this the A side of the record? I don't know if this is. But this is a request for listener Butch Ford. Came out in December of 1961. The group is called the Montells. The Montells. It's on Universal Records. It's a rare 45. It's called That's All Right With Me. This is for Butch.
That's all right with me.
Why did you leave me?
That's all right with me.
So hard to go again.
Me.
I love you so.
Going out to Butch Ford, their rare 45 by the Montells. December 61, that's on Vince Rago's Universal label out of Wilmington, Delaware. That's all right with me. The flip side's Union Hall, I think. Times Square Records, did they reissue that record? I think they did. And Vince Rago also owned the Richie label. Lots of great tunes on the Richie record label. Let's continue here. We move into 1962 with a request for Ryan Heisey. We go to Philadelphia, PA. You know this group's big hit in 1957 was a big number one hit. First came out on the Singular label. Then it was picked up by ABC Paramount Records. The song was called At the Hop. This, I think, was their, or the B-side to their last charted record, which came out on the Guidon label, written and produced by Johnny Madera and David White. Now, David White was a member of this group, but he left in the early 60s, probably right when they signed with Swan Records, I think, possibly. But anyway, this features Danny Rapp on lead. This is going out to Ryan Heisey, November 62 for Danny and the Juniors on the Guidon label. It's a B-side. It's called Now and Then.
Now and then, do you remember all the fun we had together? We thought our love would last forever. Then all of our plans fell through, but I still think of you now and then. When I feel lonely, not a friend
going out to Ryan Heisey in our YouTube chat room there. That is Danny and the Juniors, Danny Rapp on lead. That's on the Guidon label out of Philadelphia. Now and Then is the name of the tune, released in November of 1962. We're going to get out of here early tonight, folks, as we continue here. Let's go to California with this request for listener Timothy in our YouTube chat room. This singer, originally from Blythe, California, began recording back in 1951, but in 1958, he was the lead singer for the Shields. If you had that big hit of theirs called You Cheated. But here he is on Jim Lee's Indigo record label out of Hollywood, California. Recorded on many labels. Recorded on Guidon and Contender and Rendezvous and Don and Heart Records. I'm still looking for that release on the Don label by him. I think he also recorded as Frankie Day on the Caddy label. I'm talking about Frankie Irwin. Frankie Irwin, and this is by request for Timothy, January 62. It's on Indigo Records, Frankie Irwin with the song Such a Fool.
Such a fool. Ooh. When it comes to loving you, I don't care if gray skies are blue, just as long as I have you. Is love a joy or a game that you're playing with my heart? I don't care. care as long as you're near me. And our love's a flame. I'm such a fool when it comes to loving you. I don't care if gray skies are blue, just as long as I have you. Is love a joy or a game that you're playing with my heart? I don't care as long as you're near me. And our love's a flame. I'm such a fool when it comes to loving you. I don't care if gray skies are blue, just as long as I have you. Just as long as I have you, pretty baby. Just as long as I have you. Just as long as I have you. Yes, my darling. Just as long as I have you.
That's going out to Timothy there, Frankie Irwin. Frankie Irwin, January 62 on the Indigo record label. Such a Fool is the name of the tune. We stay in 1962 with a request for Jerry Nays, and we head back. We go back to the Bronx, New York for this group. Their first release came out on the Mermaid label back in 1961. They then signed with Vinnie Catalano's Blast label for this release. There were two different groups, by the way. We'll talk about this. But the first time I heard this was on the Gus Gossard show. He would play both sides of this 45 on his show. As this charted nationally, number 63 on Cashbox, 51 on Billboard. This was a number 11 record on WAMS in Wilmington, Delaware, and also on WAAT if you were listening in Trenton, New Jersey. Oh, and so Charlene, you added WNDR in Syracuse. These things have to be rechecked on ARSA. I never would have said the 11. I would have said the 8. But anyway, this is, it features a Dennis Kesterbaum on lead. This is from April 62. This is going out to Jerry Nays, and these are the Excellence on Blast with their tune called Coney Island Baby.
You're my Coney Island baby.
to put the other record on here as I'm reading all the chatter. Anyway, there you go. That's for Jerry Nays in there. That brings back memories of the Gus Gossard Show to Johnny G. Maybe it brings back memories to you, too. Those are the Excellents, April 62. It's on the Blast label. Coney Island Baby is the name of the tune. Dennis Kestenbaum, he's the lead singer on that tune. John Cuse, I think he took over the group and he sings it, he's singing it out now if you go see the Excellents perform. But Dennis Kestenbaum, he was the lead singer on the group. And they have their other releases on the label. It's not them, it's a different group. I think it's a group called the Mascots that also recorded on Blast Records, but it's a totally different group. Now, for you collectors out there, Reed, you mentioned it, the RCA press, that's not the first press, that's actually the second press of the record. The first press is the Blast that looks like there is a blast of those white things like something exploding. That's the first way versus the people always thought that the black block print with the RCA pressing was first. No, it's second. But actually this was booted too, by the way, and you can tell because the record is much smaller and the print is different. I can tell on the Blast 45s of the originals and the seconds. But anyway, let's continue here. Now, last week I played a request for Timothy on George Gulner's N record label. The group was called the Delvettes, and I played the B-side. It was actually an alternate flip. It was called Will You Love Me in Heaven. That one there, I featured the second release from January 62. It first came out in December of 61 with I Want a Boy for Christmas as the other side. But we're going to play, I guess, the A side of the record. And it was a request, I think, Sterling, you requested this side. So we're going to send this one out to Sterling. These are the Delvettes. The Delvettes from January 62 on the N label. It's called Repeat After Me. This is for Sterling, Sugar Bear Sterling.
I can hardly wait until that lucky day when I hear the preacher say,
repeat after me, repeat after me.
That's going out to Sugar Bear Sterling. There you go, the Del Vets, January 62, at least on that release. It's on the George Golner's N record label. It's called Repeat After Me. I will not chew gum in class. You got to write that. I will not chew gum during Johnny G's Vinyl Treasure Show. There you go. As I'm losing my mind here. Let's continue here. Let's go back to the Bronx, New York. This time for listener Amnon. This group first recorded as the Twilights on the Finesse record label in 1959. I think it was My Heart. They do a nice rendition of My Heart Belongs to Only You on the Finesse label. But then they changed their name to the Embers when they signed with Jody and Gene Malice's Empress label. They had four singles on Empress. This is their third, written by first tenor of the group. And he is also on lead. And it's not here, Charlene. What's the lead singer? Anyways, from June, I didn't get a chance to check these. So this is from June 62. This is for Amnon. These are the Embers on Empress Records. It's called Abigail for Amnon.
Well, woke up this morning. She's gone now and left me, wouldn't even say so long. I'm gonna travel around the world, got to find that sweet little girl. If you
going out to Amnon there. Those are the Embers. The Embers from June 1962. It's on the Empress record label. Thank you, Charlene. Cal Washington, the lead singer on that. Song is called Abigail. that bumbled under at number 137, trying to hold my coffin. Bubbled under at 137 was a big number two record on WPGC in Washington, D.C. I've never seen it on the Black Styrene Empress label. I guess it's there. I don't know. I prefer the vinyl press on the yellow label. That's what I say. Anyway, let's continue here. We move into 1963 now. We go out to Los Angeles, California for this next group. This group is a combination of multiple groups. I think the Sharps and who else was in this group? Al Frazier was a member. John Harris, Carl White, and Turner Wilson. Collectively, they were known as the Rivingtons, and they had a number of releases on Liberty, I think seven. This was their sixth release. This was first recorded by the Jive Bombers. That's it, the Jive Bombers. You got to put that in the research, Charlene. The Jive Bombers recorded this song initially, I think, for Savoy Records, what, in 57, possibly? But this is an August 63 release, and it's a request for my number one California listener, Matey Campboy. Let's give a listen to the Rivingtons. Carl White on lead. This is on Liberty Records, and they're doing the tune, a cover of the Jive Bombers. The song is called Cherry. For Matey. And the Rivingtons by request for Matey Campboy from August 63. The Rivingtons on the Liberty label, their rendition of the tune Cherry, that evidently goes back to the Mills Brothers and Louis Armstrong. That's got to be back in, what, into the 40s possibly, would have to be. But anyway, there you go. And I featured it on a vinyl press too, Reed, as I prefer vinyl over styrene every day of the week. You know that song by the Students? That's what I say. We continue here. We are in 63. This 45 is on the Boss label. This is a request for listener Butch Ford, as this group is known as the Rennells, and they were named after their lead singer. His name is Rennell Bowen, and this is on the Boss record label, owned by R.C. Robinson. So this is from 1963. This is going out to Butch Ford. These are the Rennells on Boss Records. It's called Blue Island.
There is an island, a blue island, where everyone in search of their love goes. So I took a trip around the world in search of my idol girl, a girl with all black hair, with looks beyond compare. We stopped one night at that age, all the men they wanted to stay all that
going out to Butch Ford. Butch Ford requested that tune there by the Rennells. Rennell Bowen, the lead singer, 1963. Came out on the Boss record label. Blue Island is the name of the tune. Four more 45s to go before we sign off here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. This one is a request for Timothy, and I haven't checked. I haven't played this record in a long, long time, so I don't know about this information about this tune, but it's on the Beam record label. Supposedly, this record first issued on the Nougat label, N-E-W-G-E-T Records, and a tune written by B. Jr. It was produced by Richard Barrett, and it's from April of 64. This group is called The Messengers. This is for Timothy. The Messengers on the Beam label. This charted. This was number 20 on WWIN in Baltimore, Maryland. The song is called Darling. That's in parentheses. Darling, this is how I feel. This is for Timothy.
Darling, this is how I feel. no one could ever hold me the way you do. No one could ever kiss me and thrill me like you do. And I just won't say now, baby. Oh, you love me with all your heart and soul. I know, because you gave me your heart forevermore. And I just want to say that now.
Be Billy Mashburn, possibly. I didn't get a chance to research it. The Messengers there, April 64 on the Beam label, Darling, This Is How I Feel. That's requested by Timothy here. We are in 1964. We go back to Brooklyn with a request for Jerry Nazen. They named themselves after the musical Camelot. First recorded for the Anko label in 1963. And I think they have a release on Crimson. And this one's on Al Silver's Ember record label. This charted number 13 on WTRY in Troy, New York. This is from August of 1964. This is for Jerry Nazen. These are the Camelots. The Camelots on the Ember label. And their tune is called Pocahontas.
Well, cherry blossoms in the summertime. See a deer drink of water from a mountainside. To know all of these things that surround you are true. To know they mean love and laughter and they're meant for you. Pocahontas, Pocahontas. An Indian friend says, oh, that was her fame. From a babbling brook to see a snow-capped mountain from a mountaintop. And in the valley below, where the grass is so green, the chipmunk and the squirrel are in a lasting dream. Pocahontas, Pocahontas, an Indian friend says, oh, that was her fame. She had long black hair, feather in a bonnet. She wore moccasin boots with 100 bells upon it. Pocahontas,
That's going out to Jerry Nazen in our YouTube chat room. Those are the Camelots. Camelots on the Ember label from August 64. Song entitled Pocahontas. They also recorded as the Harps on the Lori label. Another great two-sided 45. Two more 45s to go before Johnny G signs off here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. Up next, a request for Jimmy Amato. Actually, it's a flip side request, as last week I featured Darnell and the Dreams out of Yonkers, New York, with the song called The Day Before Yesterday. Came out on the West Side label in 1964. Featured, what's her name? Darnell Jessime. Yes, Darnell Jessime on lead. And Jimmy, I think you requested the flip side. It's a great two-sided 45. So we'll send it out to Jimmy Amato, 1964, Darnell and the Dreams on West Side Records. It's called I Had a Love. This is for Jimmy. As by request for Jimmy Amato there, 1964, Darnell and the Dreams. Darnell Jessime, she's the lead singer on that. She's out of Yonkers, New York. That's not too far away from Johnny G. You know, I'm in Westchester County here. Yonkers is in Westchester County, and I'm in Terrytown here, so that's not too far. But anyway, that's the flip side of The Day Before Yesterday, that song entitled I Had a Love. That's going to do it for Johnny G. and the Vinyl Treasure Show. I want to thank you for joining Johnny G, listening to original vinyl 45s out of my collection. If you want to get in touch with me, send me an email at vinyltreasures@aol.com. If you missed any of the program, it'll be available immediately once I shut down. So if you want to look, if you want to read the chatter, you got to wait. It takes a few hours for the chatter to be posted. But if you don't care about the chatter and you just want to see the records, or you want to just view it on your ITV, you can tune in immediately right after I sign off. It should be there. And if it's not there because it's blocked by the copyright police, then you can go to my website, vinyltreasures.net. I will upload the show there. I do it, you know, before I shut down the PC for the night. But thank you all for tuning in tonight. Hope you heard some tunes that you enjoyed. And those of you that sent me requests, I hope you enjoyed the requests that I featured for you. And if you have any others, send them to me at vinyltreasures@aol.com. Also, subscribe to my YouTube channel and also click the thumbs up and the bell to get email notifications. And also those people listening on Oldies and More Radio, thank you for tuning in to the Overtime. And I'll be back next Saturday night at 9 p.m. Eastern Time, right here on YouTube, and at midnight on Oldies and More Radio. And I'll be on Wednesday evening. I'm on Wednesday evenings now with my All 60s. I feature soul records out of my collection. It starts at 9 p.m. Eastern Time, 9 to 12 on Wednesday evening. So join me if you dig the 60s. If you don't, you like the 50s, as many of you guys do, that's fine also. But either way, Johnny G is always available. Thank you again. Thank you, Charlene, for all your help. We're closing the show tonight. A special request here for listener Mike Sape in our YouTube chat room. He's dedicating this song to you, Jimmy Amato, and also tell Louis Silvani. So this is a special dedication from Mike Sape to Jimmy Amato and Louis Silvani. This is actually a cover song. This is from the 1951 play, I guess it was a Broadway show, The King and I, and there was a movie, I think. But the group, it's the group's only release. This came out on the Stallion label. The group is called The Loves, L-U-V-S. The Loves came out in 1965. It's on the Stallion label. I got a few records on this label. It's called We Kiss in the Shadow. Anyway, that's it. Time for Johnny G to kiss off here. Thank you all for tuning in again. I will see you again, as I mentioned, next Saturday night. Again, everybody have a safe and happy week, and I'll see you here next Saturday night. If not, I'll see you on Wednesday evening at 9. Just want to say, everybody, so long. Here you go, Mike, for Jimmy and Louie, The Loves. Okay, folks, that does it. Is the video much clearer tonight? I think the video is better tonight. I was playing around. It's the reds are really vibrant. That's what it is with this thing. I went and I checked out the ratings of this. So each webcam has their pluses and minuses, I guess. But anyway, here is the loves. See, the reds don't look that well. But anyway, thank you all again for tuning in tonight. Johnny G's got this cough. It's allergies is what it is. And what do I need to take? What do they call that thing that they take for the... Because the nostrils are dry and probably a post-nasal drip. But what are you going to do? But thank you all again. Sorry for the shorts, but I got this... I got these stitches in my leg. They're a pain in the neck. And I can't have any, you know, anything rubbing against it. It's not good. It's not bleeding anymore, but I got to get them removed Friday. But so anyway, I got to go a whole week. But anyway, I got to start pulling out some 60s records for Wednesday. I got some time. But anyway, thank you again for tuning in tonight. Again, tell your friends about the show and become a subscriber to Johnny G's Vinyl Treasure Show again. So once again, folks, good night. Stay well. Sleep tight. See you next time. Bye-bye, everybody. Really? That detailed? Imagine.